Hey there everyone, welcome to Corey's Datapad for another Star Wars lore video. Today we're going to be talking about Star Wars video games. Not our Star Wars video games, but video games in Star Wars and how they actually seem to be pretty bad. We don't see a whole lot of them, but today we're going to talk about a couple instances where we do see in-universe video games used, and why I think they sound kind of terrible. The first example we'll talk about aren't strictly video games per se. In the X-Wing books in particular, and in other places where starfighter combat is a focus, there are multiple mentions of training simulators, and these come up pretty much everywhere throughout Legends and canon. They're essentially large cockpit-shaped boxes for pilots to sit in and go full VR for a training simulation, flying through older historic battles and learning different strategies, as well as prepping for upcoming battles. In canon, we see them in the Rebels episodes at Skystrike Academy. The original A New Hope radio drama includes a sequence where Luke is tested in a flight sim as well before joining Red Squadron. Generally, these sims, based on the visual indications from both the Rebels that we already mentioned and comics within Legends, seem to have been built to simulate one type of fighter, and the cockpit was meant to be as accurate as possible. But it does kind of give us an indication of what tech was there for some sort of video gamey experience. When it comes to direct, purpose-built video games sold and used as such, we have a couple examples that do come up. First is one that we've actually mentioned in a recent video on Grand Admiral Milton Tackle, the CS-10 Imperial Battle Simulator, made by a company named Placinia Entertainments. This was a battle simulator for mass consumption which seems to have been in the vein of an RTS game, and which was used as much for propaganda as for entertainment, marketing itself as including 12 of the Empire's greatest battles, though it did also include a scenario editor. Next up we have a flight simulator game that was played by Jaina and Jason Solo, along with their friends Lobaka the Wookiee and Tenel Ka, the Hapen Princess, and Young Jedi Knight's Darkest Night. This seems to have involved a small hollow platform that the kids were seated around and each controlled a starfighter, not even in VR. Honestly, it seems like a much lower tech, kind of worse version of Squadrons where everyone's kind of sitting around looking down at their fighter, which gets to what I typically noticed while making this video. These games seem super limited. A lot of them were written about in the 90s, and like a lot of computer-based tech in the 90s and sci-fi, there doesn't seem to have been much presumed progression there between the tech level that we would have had and in Star Wars. Unlike our own games, a lot of these games seem to be single-purpose computers rather than anything like consoles or personal computers with games that we'd have now. The same is true of things like the Dejarik board on the Millennium Falcon, the game R2 and Chewie were playing in Episode 4, though that's more of a board game. These games end up always kind of feeling like those cheap systems you'd have gotten in the 90s and early 2000s that had one, maybe two games on it and would seem kind of cool at first, but then you realize like half the graphics are actually painted on the screen and it's just really disappointing. Anyways, there's one more video game we should talk about which is technically not canon, but actually seems to be pretty decent. Gundark Trainer from the Jedi Academy Return of the Padawan comic book. These kids' comics were never considered canon, but this game, which is a clear Pokemon ripoff, is a lot more akin to our own real-world video game setup. You seem to just train your Gundark up and then you'd rip people's arms off. According to this book as well, Palpatine was a big epic gamer, so there's that. That's gonna do it for our look at video games in Star Wars though, a pretty niche topic, but still one that I thought was fun. Hope you've enjoyed the video, if so, consider leaving a like or subscribing for more. And if there's another topic you'd like to see me cover in a future video, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.